In this video, I'm going to show you how to install WordPress 4.7 with 2017 WordPress theme on your Windows 7 environment locally using XAMPP server. So make sure that you already have XAMPP installed on the computer. If you want to use a different XAMPP server, you can definitely do so. So welcome to my channel. This is TapTube and my name is Amulya. And I'm going to walk you through to install WordPress 4.7 with REST API that you get with 4.7 and WordPress 2017 theme. So make sure you already have installed a server of your choice. You can choose from these three servers. So XAMPP server, that is freely available. You can download it on your Windows environment, 64-bit and 32-bit. Now, if you are on Mac, you can use this XAMPP server. This is also available for Windows. If you want to use it, you can use it for Windows as well. Now, for this purpose, for this video tutorial, I'm going to use XAMPP, and I already have installed on my Windows. This is also available on Linux and OS X. That's Mac. So I assume that you already have installed one of these servers, and then you are running at least Apache and MySQL on your computer. So I'm using this XAMPP and I'm running Apache and MySQL. If you have any issues, let's say that your server is not working properly, you simply have to reboot your system and then relaunch your server and run Apache and MySQL. So that's it, and I'm going to close it. It will run in the background. You can see it here. And now you need to download WordPress 4.7. So WordPress 4.7.1 is a really good thing that is coming, which has already been launched. It's already available. So you get a lot of new things with WordPress 4.7. That it comes with RESTful APIs. And if you want to learn more about RESTful APIs, WP RESTful APIs, you can learn it on references, this page, which is here. Or you can go on to its any other pages. You may find it on other platforms like GitHub and all. So you can more learn about RESTful APIs in general on the internet, on YouTube, on Google, or wherever you like to. And then to install WordPress 4.7 on your computer, I'm going to download it. So click on download and choose this zip file. Once you have downloaded it, you simply have to extract it. So I already have downloaded and extracted on my desktop. So this is the WordPress 4.7 which I extracted. Now I need to put in the XAMPP htdocs folder. So I'm going to htdocs from here. However, you can go from start computer to main drive like C, XAMPP, and then htdocs. Here it is, okay. Here you need to create a folder. I'm going to close this one. Create a folder. So I'm going to click on new folder and I'm going to name it WP, and that's it. I'm going to open that WP folder and I need to just copy or just select all and drag it over here. So that has been dragged over to this folder in htdocs. I don't need this, so I can delete it later on. So this is done. Now I need to close. I can simply close it. And then I can go on here and pull up the localhost because my server is already running. And the folder name for that particular WordPress 4.7. So I named it WP and then hit enter. Now you're going to install WordPress on your computer. So select the language of your choice. You got a hell lot of languages now. I'm going to select English, United States, click on continue, and here it says you need these things: database name, database username, password, host, So host is localhost, yeah. So to create that, you open a new tab and go on to localhost, only localhost, and this takes you to the server dashboard. That's XAMPP for me, and then go on to PHP my admin page. Here you need to create a database, so you can simply go on to databases. If you know about how to the queries, MySQL queries, you can execute them from here, or you can simply create one from here. So I'm going to name it WP. That's the name of the database, and I'm going to create. So going to click create. So when you create a database, phpMyAdmin creates the database without no table, and but this creates a root user, so you already have a username root without no password. So on my localhost, I don't need any specific password for SQL. So I'm going to click on, let's go and name the WP for the server database, and username is yes root. Password, I haven't gotten any password. Root, I'm just going to delete it. And database host is localhost. And WP table prefix, that's absolutely perfect. I'm going to submit it. And are you sure it exists? Yes. Submit. Oh, WP, I'm sorry. And then click submit. What happened? Oh no, I'm sorry. No password, right? Then click submit, run the install, and then it's going to ask for the site title. I'm going to name it WordPress 4.7 with REST API, right? So this is good thing. Username, I'll keep it admin. Password, admin. If you're going to keep this same password, you'll have to confirm that you would like to continue with weak password. So click on here, username admin at admin.com. I do not want to submit to any search engines. So I'm going to click on, so make sure you have done everything. WordPress 4.7 with REST API. And then click on install WordPress. So this is going to install WordPress. And it takes time initially. So you please be patient with me. Alright, now it's asking me to enter the password. Thank you for your patience. I'm going to put in the password. I'm also going to click on remember me. And you are in 4.7 WordPress locally installed on your computer. Now, to make sure that you already have 2017 theme, so this is 2017 theme selected. However, you can change it to whatever you want to. You simply click on add new and search for the specific theme that you want for this localhost, and if you want to learn other themes. So this is how you can do so. So you already have 2017 installed. Let me quickly go ahead and visit the website. So this is how it looks like. To check the responsiveness of this 2017 theme, you simply have to resize the browser, and this is how it looks on mobile devices. This is it for this video. Make sure you learn more about the REST APIs, and so WordPress 4.7 has come up with a lot of new things, and you're going to learn a lot about them. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe. If you liked anything, please leave the comment. If you did not like, also leave the comment. And once again, thank you so much and have a good day.